Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. Welcome to the channel. If you are new here, please subscribe. This video is gonna be about the difference, because it's a difference between the Bahamas and Canada, from my experience, and even I would say Caribbean, you know, for a lot of countries. You can compare this with Canada, but number one, Canada, as you don't know, Canada is very diverse. It's big on inclusion, has so much people from many walks of life with different beliefs, different culture, different background, and it is accepting to all of those differences. So with that being said, if you come to Canada, you're gonna see a lot of people with different beliefs and all types of different religion. When it comes to Muslims, Buddhism, Hinduism, atheists, like, you're gonna see everybody, and you might end up making connections with all of them, because it's Canada, they're everywhere. Like, for instance, in my country, in the Bahamas, it's a Christian nation, so, jeez. I'm just guessing, but it has to be like 95% of the Bahamas, although they might not practice it, they might not practice. I mean, they might practice Christianity, but we know that there are people, you know, that know about Jesus Christ, and at the end of the day, we all know that they are lukewarm. They think that they're for Jesus, but they are not. And that's even in America, that's everywhere we go. But overall, it's still a Christian country, and we're gonna have probably Anglican, Catholics, non-denominations, Seventh-day Adventists in the Bahamas. You're not gonna see a bunch of Muslims. You're not gonna see a bunch of people, Hinduism. You're not gonna see a lot of, you're just not gonna see a lot of that in the Bahamas versus Canada. Oh man, Jews are gonna see everything. And also, number two would be that Canada is very liberal. So, in the education system, even if you're coming here for college, especially depending on your program, you're gonna have a lot of, you know, ideology, a lot of theories that you're gonna have to study about the ABCD community, and about different cultures, different beliefs, all of those things you're going to be exposed to. Versus the Bahamas, or different, maybe other people from in different countries, it's kind of probably stuck on, maybe even if it's Hinduism, if it's Muslims, like if majority of people in your country is Muslims, you're not gonna be seeing a whole lot of other things. You're just gonna be seeing a lot of things just based off of that religion. So that's the same thing with the Bahamas versus Canada, is that you're in the Bahamas, you're not gonna probably see a LGBT poster, you're not gonna see a bathroom that is for both sex, you know, you're not gonna see that. And in Canada, people are very liberal, you know, they fight for their rights, they voice their opinions, it's very liberal in Canada, if you don't know. And also, one more thing is that there is a lot of homeless people in Canada. There are a lot of people with mental illnesses, and we all know that the medical industry have a lot of names for that, but for me, If you ain't filled with the Holy Spirit, then you're filled with something else telling you go kill yourself and all this other thing. Yeah, so anyways, that's for another topic. But you're gonna see a lot of that. And like, for instance, in my country, yeah, we have homeless people, But, however, in Canada, like, they are allowed to go wherever they want to go. They're allowed to do whatever they want to do. You know, they can just go on the bus stop. I mean, just go on the buses, go on the train stations, you know, sleep, go in the bathrooms, you know, do whatever they got to do. And it's not a problem unless maybe it becomes a safety issue. And then you'll have to press the red button on the train or whatever, and then the police would have to come and all of that. But you're going to see a lot of that, especially if you're doing like public transportation. It can be scary. I remember I was on a situation on the bus, and oh man, like, I was so close to the guy, and he was going bonkers. And he went like over to the bus driver, and child, the bus driver stopped that bus and said, "Yo, everybody get off, because it ain't happening today." Everybody had to get off the bus because, like, the bus driver literally fared for his life. He's like, it's not worth it. It ain't happening. And I ain't blame him. I'm gonna do the same thing. But that is what happened versus the Bahamas. I don't wanna laugh. In the Bahamas, that's not happening. That's not happening. First of all, it's not happening. First of all, if you're coming on that on the public transportation, you have to pay. They're not just gonna let, no, that would not happen in the Bahamas. And you know, I do feel that a lot of people are homeless in Canada because it is rent. That's another difference. Rent is really high in Canada. Rent is really high. And also, you have to understand that this is a country that is for like indigenous people. So like, a lot of people came here and their families are back home, like back in their home country. So sometimes it's maybe only them and their immediate family. And if something happens to you financially, if you're in a financial crisis, you don't have your mother to go to. You don't have your aunt or your cousins to go to live with. Maybe it's just you. And if you're going through a financial crisis, then you're homeless. It's simple as that. Because you don't have no family members that you can go to that can support you if you're in need. And I think that is one of the reasons why there are a lot of people that are homeless in Canada. And on top of also, the rent is extremely expensive. And that's another thing. The Bahamas, spending $3,000 on rent in the Bahamas, that's crazy. I would, like, unless you're like going really, really in a really, 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 really good neighborhood, $3,000, you're looking like at West in a really, really nice apartment. $3,000 in Canada a month, that's probably, it's not gonna give you much. Like, if you're gonna be in a nice apartment, but that's not like no 4 bedrooms or 3 bedrooms. That's probably a 2-bedroom. If you want to be in a really, really nice apartment in Canada, you're gonna spend at least $2,500 at least for bare minimum. At least. And that's gonna be, it's so expensive. And like, it's gonna be small, it's gonna be like a little deck. It's expensive, child. It's expensive. So that is a reason why a lot of people, you know, and I think though this is in every country, is that nowadays you need a partner, you need someone. It doesn't have to be a husband, but you need you and someone else to come in agreement that, hey, we're gonna stick together and we're gonna do this thing called life together, where it's your sister, your brother, I don't know what it is, but y'all two have an agreement, y'all trying to work things out. I know that's kind of difficult to have, but that's where we're coming to now, is that it is so difficult to do things on your own. You have to be like a 6-figure if you're gonna do this thing and pay these bills on your own. And that's what both countries, because if I didn't have my husband in the Bahamas, I'm gonna be in problems. If I didn't have my husband in Canada, I'm gonna be in problems. So that's why I say, if you have to be six figures, you're gonna have to be, you know, if you're doing it alone in any country, that's just how the world is. That's just how it is now in the world, that you just have to do it. You have to do it with someone else. You have to be in groups now to make it, to do things in this world. But that's another issue. And also with transportation in Canada versus the Bahamas, it's a different difference. Like, first of all, if we in the Bahamas, if we want to like stop the bus, we do this thing where, like, y'all know it's like this little wave. It's this little wave, and we're standing up on the side of the road, like this little wave, and then the bus stops. And in Canada, we have like this post that we have to, that people have to stand by. And if you're not at that post, sister, brother, you're getting leave. Bye-bye, okay? And in the Bahamas, no, the bus driver, you know, they would wait for you. They would, you know, they see you running, you know, running for your daily life, and they would wait. In Canada, let me show you something. These bus drivers don't wait. I think if they're a mother, okay? They don't care. They're not waiting on you. If you're like a split second, or even if they're on the light and like the light just turned red, and if it's not on that post, they're not letting you in. If you're a split second, like a tip, they're not slowing down, they're not letting you. They do not care. Versus the Bahamas, like, they would wait, you know. Listen, Canada, they're not waiting for you. Either you're there or you ain't. I don't, like, you miss a split second, they don't care. Sorry. Also, in Canada, with transportation, is that we use Presto. It's a card that you would just swipe, just tap, actually. And now you can also use a debit card, where you can just tap, and it's like $360 for the buses. And then if you want to go, and you have like 2 hours of free access until you have to pay again. And versus the Bahamas, the bus drivers do not accept debit, credit card, any type of just cash, okay? And in the Bahamas, we say bus stop. That's how we stop the bus. Bus stop. In Canada, you have to press. It's like a little yellow rope. You would pull that, or you could always just press the request button, and then the bus would stop. Don't say no bus stop. Don't say no bus stop there, because they ain't stopping. If you in press stop, so be it. Also, in Canada, the bus have their own, you know, they stop where they supposed to stop. It ain't, you know, my host is like, right here, but you're gonna stop further, like, so can you please just, no, they're not stopping. You're gonna have to walk, sweetie, I'm sorry. It is what it is. My work is right, you're stopping right here, and the light is on red, can you let me out, please? No, girl, you gotta wait. You're gonna have to wait. It is so funny, because the difference just, it makes me laugh sometimes. But you're gonna have to wait. Okay, you're gonna have to wait. I'm sorry. So the transportation systems for sure is completely different from back home in the Bahamas. It is completely different. And also a difference, obviously, we know that, no, Canada gets really cold, and like in Canada, you're gonna experience all of the seasons, spring, fall, winter, like, it's so beautiful. Like right now, like, look at that, it's so beautiful. And in the Bahamas, in these Caribbean islands, it's just heat, it's just summer. Like, it's summer and winter, it's summer. Like, during the holiday seasons, you can wear pom-pom shorts and tank top. It's hot on Christmas. It's hot in December. It's hot. It's hot 24/7. It is no break. You might have a little, you know, maybe a day where it's it ain't nothing to brag about, you know? You might be like a little long sleeve, you might. But other than that, it's summer all year. All year, 12 months, it's summer, it's hot, it's sticky, it's hot. In Canada, you're gonna experience all of the seasons, okay? Also, in Canada, education system, like when it comes to public and public in the Bahamas, with public in Canada, they don't know. See, education system, it's British. You know, a lot of the Caribbean countries were under the British education system, and the British is like, we don't play that. Like, we're stern in education. Like, the teachers are like, bop, 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 bop. So they don't play that. In Canada, they're more free. It's more play-based curriculum. So when you're in the school in the Bahamas, they're gonna give you a supply list of a lot of textbooks, a lot of things, a lot of pencils and pens and this and that. And it's a whole long list of things that you should get before your child attends school. Versus in Canada, you don't have to do anything. Just bring your child and bring their lunch and their breakfast or whatever. And that's all they need. And I guess the public school would supply everything else, but the Bahamas and also Jamaica, other Caribbean countries, British don't play. Like, I'm gonna need you to be reading, I'm gonna need you to be writing, I'm gonna need you to like be stern. And like I said, in Canada, not so much. So if you put in comparison someone in that same grade one versus someone who's in public school in Canada, you know, someone that's in the Caribbean, I'm just saying, this is not no bash or anything, but they're probably, could probably be more, I guess, developmental wise, a little bit more ahead, just because of the curriculum. And just based off the British curriculum, they're gonna be a little bit more advanced versus someone who's a grade one in the public system in Canada. Like I said, because it's in those early ages, it's more play-based. It's more based off of hands-on experiences and stuff like that, versus in the Bahamas, it's ABC, 1, 2, 3, get it, you don't get it, you know? It's stern on that. So that's the difference. And that's with a lot of the Caribbean countries, but that's one of the major differences. And this is so random that it's on this list, but I have to say this. Meat in Canada is expensive, please. Ooh. If anyone is new to Canada or been to Canada maybe longer than me, please let me know where y'all get meat, because meat is expensive. Oh man, meat is expensive. Oh, I don't know if maybe I'm shopping at the wrong place. I went to so much different places, but it's expensive everywhere. I don't know, maybe inflation in the Bahamas or in other countries maybe went up from I was there last December. But meat is expensive, and it kind of scares me, because I'm thinking like what is the meat back home, maybe, like, what are they putting in the meat? Maybe it's downgraded meat, like, I don't know, like, why is it, it's a big difference. Why is it so expensive? Like, let me know if you're in the Bahamas, like, how much is Like, how much is chicken breast? Like, really, it's expensive. I'm just gonna go vegan at this point. But that is so random, but it does. Y'all know I'm cheap. I'm like, bro, why? This is so expensive. It's killing me. But that's all I have for this. I know it's so much. It is so much of the differences, but I guess this is just gonna be part one for that, for this video. So that's all I have so far. I hope you guys like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see y'all in the next video. Bye.